The band called the Beach Boys in Hawthorne, California, after my dad from the Midwest to the coast of California, met Brian Wilson and his brothers and his cousin, and said, you know what, we should write a song about, you know, California, about surfing. Actually, it was Dennis Wilson's idea, I have to be honest. Though he never got credit for it. He was probably the sexiest Beach Boys in the band. So we liked to have his presence on the drums because he was like our Ringo Starr. But it was his idea originally. I'm getting a little feedback up here, Jeff. I'm not sure why. Do you hear it out there at all? At any rate, I think what we'll do is play that first song for you and see what you think, and then we'll work into some of the more recent stuff. It's only 50 years old, you know, the later stuff. So anyway, so this other one, we're still getting a little hum up here, you guys. A little, bring the monitors down, or bring the PA down, maybe. So this is a reminiscent of, we were really the first vocal surfing group, let's put it that way, at the time. There were a lot of instrumentals, so. Let's try it out. You want to try it? Let's give it a try. Okay, what key are we in, guys?
Surfing is the only life, the only way for me now. Surf, surf with me. Woke up this morning, turned on my radio. Now I'm picking up the surfing scene to see if I can go. When the DJ tells me surfing is fine. Well, oh my baby, and I will have a good time. That you ought to know. Yeah, my surfing lights are rising. My board is losing wax.
My son, Matt Jardine, who's my Brian Wilson voice, and we toured with Brian for quite a while. Last year, toured with Brian.
Yeah, summer.
Getting back to this anyway, I should introduce everybody. Robin DeGregory, guitar, lead guitar over here. Thanks, Robin. Debbie Scherer on keyboards, the better looking of the bunch. Bobby Figueroa on drums. Bobby. Yeah. Bobby and Eddie Carter on bass. Bobby and Eddie were the our original Beach Boy band members way back when we started, shortly after the surfing era. And I'm glad to have them back, because it's great to have that Beach Boy feeling on stage again, the authentic Beach Boy feeling. So we had to have another hit record. And, you know, the record companies like to have follow-ups. And that was our first recording ever, so we were kind of a little new at it, so we thought we'd add an extra chord to the next song to kind of give it, it had the same kind of feeling, you know, the same idea and tempo. It goes something like this.
Let's go surfing now, everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me. Far to the islands this year, so if you're gonna give it.
Catch a wave, baby, sitting on top of the world.
That's the next plane out of here, man. We're going over there pretty soon, I'm sure. Sometime. It's hard to get a gig in Hawaii. I don't know what it is. But, you know, it's easy to get to Japan or Australia or something like that, you know, over the years. But something about, we always want to hit that one little island first. I guess the airfares are cheaper if you go direct. I don't know what the deal is. But at any rate, now we'll get into some of the ballads that the Beach Boys are really famous for. This next one is, well, one of Brian Wilson's favorite, one of his first, and I don't know, it's perfect. Sorry, but they're all great, but this one's great.
Okay.
Greater, I should say.
Thank you.
grandfather's voice. Yeah, Don Jardine had this amazing voice. He'd always sing along to my dad, obviously. Always sing along to these English things. You know, not the Beatles. I love those songs from the 19th century. Anyway, I developed an interest in that. Now, Matt's come along and fill in the void here. So, car songs, going back to car songs. Yep. I think we should show everybody that, huh? What? Yeah, there you go.
We've got one in the audience here from Cincinnati, wherever he is, Gary Griffin.
Oh, no, let's talk.
And another who unfortunately died just a week ago from Columbus, Ohio, Sterling Smith, and some of his family is in the audience here today, and we just wanted to give a shout out to our Ohio Beach Boy keyboard players. Thank you so much.
So anyway, so we got ambitious to start, and somebody gave us some lyrics about cars, local disc jockey in Los Angeles, and so when we came off tour, Brian was all excited about these new songs, because they're about cars, not just girls, but cars. Girls in cars, that kind of thing. And by gosh, you know, Ed, play that bass line in this next song for us, will you? It kind of builds itself around this particular song. Yeah, isn't that cool? So, Ed, so there you are. So why don't we join Ed now on that little guy and see if we can figure out the song.
Yeah.
We'd like to switch gears again, if we may, not to pun. But this next song is really a very heartfelt, kind of introspective piece of music that, you'll get what I need when we play it. It's kind of cool. It's all about being in your room all alone and thinking of big thoughts.
There's a wound where I can go and tell my secrets to you in my room.
Debbie Scherr in my monitor. I don't hear enough of this beautiful organ piece that you're playing. Can you play a little something for us? Just play something, anything. Oh, there you go. I like that.
On my way to sunny California, on my way to spend another sunny day. Water, water, get yourself in.
Get yourself in there.
Get yourself in there.
Get yourself in there. Water.
Similarity between Central California area of where I live now and the Midwest, you know, and something about the farmhouse, you know. In fact, I live on a farm and I have a farmhouse, so it just seemed logical. And my grandfather lived up in Toledo, and then he bought a farm up there and had just beautiful memories. So I just like the idea of a nice, you know, song about and it has that nice Beach Boy vibe to it, of course, so that all works. And if you like country music, that works too. Now, Matt's going to sing one of these amazing songs that just comes out of heaven, I think. I don't know where it came from, but Brian just jotted this little thing down on a cassette recorder, and then the rest of it is history. And Matt's going to sing it for you.
Hand in hand, some drum belong to a handsome man in the town. A blind glass, aristocracy. Back through the opera glass, you see the pit in the pendulum drum. Thank you.
okay, we're finished now. We can't do any more than that. But that was beautiful, man. Thank you. Well, maybe we'll have to pick them up one more time here. We had an episode where we got sick and tired of working in California, you know, with all the amenities and all the kids around and everything. Oh, sorry, Matt. But so actually, we took a little trip to Holland.
Yeah.
In Europe to record an album.
Yeah.
Called Holland, of all things. Did that on, yeah. Yeah, and
Blondie.
To this day, we can't figure out how we ended up there. But we could have gone to the south of France, you know, maybe Provence, and have, you know, worked with the Rolling Stones in their trailer there. But at any rate, came out pretty good, I thought. And one of the singles, one of the songs on the album became a single called Sail on Sailor.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it's, yeah, it's pretty, we've got a lot of material to cover here. We could be here all night. But well, Bobby, would you help us out with this tonight? Bobby's going to say, originally it was sung by a guy named Blondie Chappell.
Yeah.
Who joined the band time when we were working. So let's see how it goes, okay? Let's tone it down a little, Matt, shall we? And get serious. Do some serious music now. Now, this one's one of my all-time, Paul McCartney's favorite songs. My favorite. They're all my favorite, but this one in particular has a special value to me. It's called God Only Knows. Woo-hoo!
'cause there are stars above you. You never need to doubt it. You make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you. If you should ever leave me, then life would still go on, believe me.
Minutes. And then I asked him again about a year later, and he said, "Oh, maybe 45. So he told Dad 10. So there you go. Brian Wilson.
Yeah, he's tapping into some of the more serious levels of spirituality, obviously. But to come up with songs like this in 10 minutes, finished, and then we have to sing them, right? It takes us forever to learn them. But I think it worked out all right, man. We're going to do this next one. Actually, this next one was my idea. It wasn't particularly original, but I thought, you know, with our harmonies, we ought to be able to sing a folk song or two at least, because I came from a folk song background, and I kind of like this group called the Kingston Trio. They had striped shirts like the one you're wearing there in the front row, and the president of the Senate even wore one tonight, and I autographed his shirt sleeve. Anyway, don't say anything. But those kind of songs, to me, they tell stories, and they're fun, and they're interesting, and with the Beach Boy harmonies, you couldn't miss. Okay. Yeah. Will you come on, Mr. Johnny? My grandfather and me, around Nassau town. I got into a fight. Well, I feel so broke up. I wanna go home. Stop the John B. sail and see how the mainsail set. Go for the captain ashore. So broken.
I've ever been on. So hoist up the Jardine,
hoist up the Jardine.
See how the mainsail, see how the mainsail. Go for the captain ashore, let me go home. Let me go home. Want to go home. Let me go home. Let me go home.
Hoist up the Jardine,
hoist up the Jardine.
This is the best trip I've ever been.
This is gonna be a challenge, man. Are you ready for it?
Okay.
Anybody can start any kind of way.
Must be kind.
everybody say with
sing along for me.
Gotta keep those loving good vibrations happening with her. Gotta keep those loving good vibrations happening with her. Gotta keep those loving good vibrations happening with her.
Help me run, 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 help
thank you. Woo, what a journey it's been. A lot of time went by, but the songs stay young, don't they? They keep you young. All you gotta just keep singing. You know, that's lucky for us, we can still sing, right? But I mean, it's you know, I'd be a carpenter, could do that. Or a lawyer, or any of that stuff. But it's great to have an ability to do that with my son, Matt Jardine here. And hello, the guys and gals. I wish I could hear Debbie better. Anyway, speaking of my father, his journey west, I more or less capsulized it in a song, which is the title of my solo album called Postcard from California. Thank you. So I thought I put together, it was just a heartfelt song about moving out west. You know, after the brief stay here in Lima, I was only six or so. I can kind of remember, I sense it more than I, you know, actually see it. But it was a wonderful time. I was very, very sad to leave. And then we moved into a really cold place called Rochester, New York.
Hey.
And Mom said, we're out of here.
It's cold.
Yep. We're out of here. So Dad starts typing away. He keeps typing. He's typing letters all the time. I can hear him at night. And he finally found a management spot in San Francisco at a blueprint company called Royal Blueprint. It was freezing. It was colder there than it was in Rochester. It's a different kind of cold in California. You can't imagine. It's like deep, you know, it gets right here under. Anyway. So Mom wanted another tropical move, a more tropical move. Ended up in the LA area, and she loved it there. So that was our journey, and this song is kind of encapsulates it. And dreams are what this nation's built on. Oops. Me a letter back, said get yourself out here fast. We'll send for your things and put you in a nice hotel. I knew I was doing good, typed it on an Underwood. My letter came all the way by U.S. mail. They said they could use a man who could read us at a blueprint plant. By the time you read this, I'll be flying over Indian Wells.
Down, I guess the snow will have to do. I'm feeling like this ain't right. I had to take the morning flight. I love you, girl, and I'm already missing you.
I tried you on the telephone, didn't find you at home. I'm not real good with words or making sweet goodbye. And maybe I'll change my plans, start up a rock and roll band. By the time it rains, it'll make you cry. Glenn Campbell came down and sang the second verse, if you want to hear a pretty good rendition of it. Matt singing Glenn's voice, voicing Glenn in that kind of, you know, I thought he did a pretty darn good job. But yeah, he was real generous about that and helped me sing the choruses. You know, whenever Glenn did something, it was always better, even though you had a particular idea. The great artists, the real good ones, will make it better. That's the only way I can explain it. That's even better than what I did. So, anyway, thanks, Glenn.
And Postcards from California, you can find on his website, aljardine.com. And Steve Miller sang on it. David Crosby sang on it. Who else we got?
Neil Young,
Stephen Stills.
The guy sang on California Saga.
A lot of great artists. From the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Flea's on there playing bass. But my favorite guys are the America guys.
Jerry Beckman, they did
a great job on a song called San Simeon. If you're ever on the West Coast and you want to see an American castle, well, that's the one. Of course, you can't get to it now. There's a landslide to the north and a dam break on the south or something. I don't know. So I don't know what they're doing for food. They're probably flying it in. Oh, the Hearst family. I suppose they could probably fly it in. Yeah. Hey, we're going to do something really dumb for you. This is as dumb as it gets.
These are all sing-along songs, so please sing with us.
Ba 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 ba
Everybody had an ocean. Yeah.
you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for having us. See you next time. Hopefully in that nice theater next door. Oh, they're beautiful. Yeah. Okay, thanks a lot for coming, everyone. Thanks for the good vibes.